I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart I have but one desire, and that one is you. No other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of.
War never changes. Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything from God to justice to simple psychotic rage. In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself no longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation. But it was not, as some had predicted, the end of the world. Instead, the apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history. For man had succeeded in destroying the world. But war never changes. In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as vaults. But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them. All except those in Vault 101. For on that fateful day, when fire rained from the sky, the giant steel door of Vault 101 slid closed and never reopened. It was here you were born. It is here you will die. Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters, and no one ever leaves.
Let's see, are you a boy or a girl? It's a boy.
A boy. We've got a son, Catherine. A beautiful, healthy baby boy.
Oh, James. We did it. A son. Our beautiful son.
You've got a bright future ahead of you, son. I'm sure of it. Look at you. Look at you. Hi there. I'm your daddy, little guy. Daddy. You're going to need a name, aren't you? Your mother and I have been talking. What do you think about... That's a good name, don't you think? Fits you perfectly. Looks like they've finished the gene projection. Let's see what you'll look like when you're all grown up. You're going to look a lot like your dad. See that, Catherine?
Oh, oh, very strapping.
It's a big world out there, son, full of all sorts of people. What about you? What kind of person are you going to be?
James?
Catherine?
James?
Catherine! She's in cardiac arrest. Start compressions. Get the baby out of here. Move, move! 1,000. 2,000. Come on. Hang on, Catherine. Hang on. Okay?
Just remember one thing. We need a doctor, not a deadbeat.
This one's on the house.
Fail to meet my expectations.
No. Don't look straight into the light, pal.
James and his cheery chatter.
Decorations,
fascinating
boys. This place will feel just like home. Come on over here, son. Come on. Walk to Daddy. Over here. There you go. My goodness, just a year old and already walking like a pro. Your mother would have been so proud. Listen, kiddo, I know you don't like it when Daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of yourself for a minute. You just stay here while Daddy runs to his office. You'll be okay, pal. I'll be back in a bit. You are quite the little explorer, aren't you? Serves me right for trying to pin you in. Come on over here. I want to show you something. See that? It was your mother's favorite passage. It's from the Bible. Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. She always loved that. All right, come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amada wants to play.
Baba.
These experiments
don't
are
be a damn fool. We experiment to prepare. We prepare to survive.
Surprise!
Stanley, you turned the lights on too fast. You blinded the poor kid.
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday!
Can you believe it? He is growing up so fast.
Happy birthday, pal. I can't believe you're already 10. I'm so proud of you. If only your
Congratulations,
mother...
young man. I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I? Down here in Vault 101, when you turn 10, well... You're ready to take on your first official vault responsibilities. So here you are. As overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000. Get used to it. You'll be getting your first work assignment tomorrow.
Enjoy your party. You're only 10 once, so have fun.
Oh man, you got a Pip-Boy. I wish I was 10.
Hey, thanks for inviting me. Really cool party and everything. I know that, Butch and I give you a hard time, but you don't take that seriously, right? Anyway, happy birthday and everything. I better get back to, you know.
What, are you two best friends now? Hey, Wally, I think Paul's gone soft on us.
Yeah, Paul. Why don't you introduce us to your new best friend?
Who do you mean, Dorkface here? Happy birthday, Dorkface.
Happy birthday! We really surprised you, didn't we? Your dad was afraid you were onto us. But I told him not to worry. You're so easy to fool. You're welcome. But really, your dad did most of it. I just helped with the decorations and stuff. Hey, I bet you can't guess what I got you for your birthday. Go on, guess. Ha! I knew I surprised you. Who's your favorite barbarian? That's right, Grognak, issue 14, and with no missing pages. I found this in a box of my father's old things, believe it or not. Imagine him reading comic books. I guess everybody was 10 once. Well, I better let you get back to mingling with your guests. We'll talk later, okay? Happy birthday.
Enjoying yourself? Happy birthday, Sonny.
Enjoying yourself? I hope you appreciate the effort Amara put into this party. She really seems to like you, for some reason. I do not allow the fact that Amata is my daughter to compromise my position as overseer. I gave her all the appropriate paternal encouragement, of course, but I could not contribute extra vault resources. That is simply what my position requires. No more, no less. I know Amata understands that perfectly well.
Are you having a nice party? 10 years old. My, my, my. Seems like only yesterday that your daddy came. Goodness, listen to me ramble. You're waiting for your present, aren't you? Fiddlesticks! What 10-year-old doesn't like presents? I was 10 once, believe it or not. My goodness, the vault was practically crowded back then. Not like today. So few young people now. But here I am rambling on again, and you listening so politely. Here you go, a nice sweet roll that I baked for you just this morning. And it's all for you. No sharing required today.
Attention, everyone! It's time to cut the cake!
Andy, wait!
Hey, happy birthday, nosebleed!
Oh, no!
I am mortified about the cake mishap. Simply mortified.
How's it going, pal?
Nice pit
Daddy,
boy.
Daddy, I told
what is
you
that?
Not to act all
One of...
I'm hungry, and that stupid robot destroyed the cake. Give me that sweet roll you got from old Lady Palmer. Oh, yeah? We'll see about that.
3,000 A-models?
I'm sorry you were joking,
what
but I'm not sure
junk.
Anyone else did.
I think you have to wind
Nonsense.
It up every morning.
People always enjoy my little speeches.
Butch,
Besides,
what do you think you're doing? Leave him alone.
It was a reminder that life is not all fun and games.
So, what do you think we should call our gang? It's gotta be totally
It's supposed to be a party.
I hope Butch didn't hurt you. You want to tell me what that was all about? Why, that little... I figured it was him that started it. He's been nothing but trouble since the day he was born. You let me handle this and try to stay out of the way.
Hey,
how
about
you all right, son?
Get it?
You
should
he didn't
try
hurt
it sometime,
you,
Daddy.
To go?
You might...
How's it going, pal?
All right, Butch.
What's Butch's problem, anyway? I can't believe he tried to start a fight at your own birthday party. What a jerk. God, he really is a butthead. Oh well, you can always count on Butch to make an ass of himself. Get it?
Hey, Officer Gomez! Nice party, huh?
Look, Butch,
can it? I've had it with you, Butch.
Your mother is going to hear about this little incident.
What
did
he tell you?
Now go on and enjoy yourself.
You didn't hear what he said to me.
I'm not going to tolerate any more of your bullying.
I know you were busy with the water purifier.
For now, just remember, I'm keeping my eye on you. Oh, sure, nothing to worry about. Me and Andy got her all fixed up again last night. Good as new.
You or me? No
way! I wasn't worried. You can fix anything, right? Anyway, I'm glad you could make it. Come on, try to look like you're enjoying yourself.
How's it going, pal?
How do you like that Pip-Boy, son? Fit all right and everything? As a matter of fact, I did. I'm glad you like it. Some may think the A-Series a bit basic, but I've always preferred them for their reliability. Don't mention it. Oh, yes, I almost forgot. Happy birthday! Not much, but I hope you like it.
How are you enjoying the party, Mrs. Palmer? I help with the decorations, you know.
Oh, really?
Hmm.
They're
snakes
lovely.
Are cool, right? Cool snakes! What do you guys think?
Sure. I mean...
Are you all right? Is Butch giving you a hard time again? Please, don't do that. I know you don't like Butch, but if you start picking fights with him, how are you any better? Don't be afraid to stand up for yourself, but don't go looking for trouble. There's trouble enough in this world without adding to it. Well now, that's more than enough lecturing for a birthday party. Go on and enjoy yourself.
Really like that one.
I'm glad you could
shut up and let me think of it.
I'm glad to be here. I think it's
Come
important
on,
to keep in touch
with
the young people,
that.
You know.
This party's pretty good, I guess. For a little kid. Balloons, party hats. Not as cool as my party, though. Remember how my dad got Andy to do magic tricks? And we all played Hunt the Mutant in the atrium? Oh, right. You weren't invited to my party. Too bad, man. It was really fun.
We need a good
part
name.
Of my job. Plus, well,
how about
little
hell baby
Weaver's
Telltale
too?
Yeah,
I
like that.
Well, it's been nice
well,
chatting with you.
Thanks. Doesn't have
I'll
you
send him right down.
Which makes
enjoying
it
yourself?
Of...
Hey, that was Jonas on the intercom. He and I have been cooking up a little surprise present. Jonas is waiting for you downstairs on the reactor level. Go ahead. I don't think anyone will mind if you slip out for a few minutes.
Your other ideas.
Hey, you having a nice time?
Come on. Try to look like you're enjoying yourself.
Happy birthday, dearie. My goodness, I hope I didn't miss the party. Of course you're not five. You're a big 10-year-old man now, aren't you? With your very own Pip-Boy. And do you know what I did? Just for the occasion, wrote you a poem. I hope you like it.
Did you know the Vault-Tec Rocco partnership?
Of course. Run along now, dearie, and have yourself a wonderful birthday. I hope you're having a good party. Did you read your poem yet? You know how to find it in your Pip-Boy, don't you?
Go on. Jonas is waiting for you downstairs.
You guys are dumb. Somebody's gotta have a better idea than those.
Thank you for coming. Oh, I got it. Oh, I hope man, this is a great one. The grease freezers. What do you guys think?
Enjoy the party, sir?
Bah! I only showed up because Amata's friends with the brat. Give them a few more minutes, and then I want that place cleaned up and everybody back to work.
Sure thing, sir. Sounds like everybody's having a good time in there. That's secure for a reason.
What are you doing down here, young man? I thought kids weren't allowed down on the reactor level. You sure are. Pip-Boy and everything. Look at that. If you can wait just one more minute, I think your dad will want to give you the surprise himself. Your dad is waiting to give you your present. Or should we just keep it?
Are you ready for your surprise? The Overseer gave you your Pip-Boy, and you're old enough to do some work, so I figure you're old enough for this. Your own BB gun. It's a little old, but it should work perfectly. Jonas found it down here. It was in pretty rough shape. Took us a good 3 months to find the parts to get it working again. You know how tough it is to find a spring that small? Good thing Butch misplaced that switchblade of his. So, what do you think? Want to give it a try? Easy now. It's only a BB gun, but it's not a toy. Let's go try it out. Jonas and I have found a nice spot for you. Follow me. What do you think? You can come down here and shoot anytime you want. Couldn't have done it without Jonas's help. You make sure to thank him.
Careful, it's a rad roach. Think you can take care of that with your BB gun? Just... Good work. That's one less rat roach to deal with. Let's get a picture together. Capture the moment. Hey, Jonas, get a picture of me with a big game hunter.
Smile!
Boys and girls have different parts.
What is your problem right anyway? So, I'm the Overseer's daughter, so what? That like, I get any kind of special treatment.
Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. As far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old boy. So yes, you have to go to class to take your goat exam. Go on now. You've got a goat to take. The Generalized Occupational Aptitude Test. Goat. Everyone here in the vault takes it when they're 16. Helps to figure out what sort of a job you'll have here in Vault 101 when you get a bit older. So, pay attention and try not to fall asleep. You know what the Overseer says? We're born in the vault, we die in the vault. Each is tested to determine their abilities, that they may work for the betterment of all vault residents. Huh. Sound familiar? That's not the way it works. And it won't do to go around asking questions like that, especially not around the Overseer. I want to tell you something now. It's important, so listen closely. This place, this vault, it's not perfect, I know, but it is your home. You're safe here. Stay on the Overseer's good side, and you always will be. You understand? You need to appreciate all you have, because what's up there on the outside, that's not the life I want for you. And it's not what your mother wanted for you either. That's what the Overseer says, isn't it? He's not about to let anyone else in, so I guess that's how it'll have to be. You're here now, and it's a hell of a lot better than being up there. All your mother and I ever wanted was for you to be safe, and you're safe here. Your mother, she was beautiful. But beyond the beauty you've seen. There's just so much those old photos can never show. And she was passionate. About life, about love. But most of all she was passionate about you. When she became pregnant, it was the happiest I had ever seen her. Ah, she had great things in mind for you. And so, time for you to stop stalling and get to class. Please, son, please, take these achievement tests seriously. The last thing I need is your mother's ghost haunting me because her only child became a garbage burner. Hey, it's not my call. Those are the rules. You're 16 now, so this year you take the goat. Come on, it's not so bad. Everyone has to take it. You'll do just fine. Take care, son. Now get out of here, and good luck.
Good morning. Stopped in to see the old man before class, eh?
Morning, Jonas.
Morning, Doc. How's things?
Have you had a chance to look over these results?
I was just going over them. Something you're worried about?
I'd just like to keep an eye on it.
No problem. I'll have my report ready this afternoon.
Sounds good. Let me know if there are any changes.
Hey there! Hey, 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 sport. It's been a while since you stopped in here to see us. It's the big goat day today, right? Hi, Stanley. Sorry to keep you waiting. What seems to be the trouble today?
I've got this headache that just won't go away. Even with the pills you gave me last week. It's the lights, I think. They hurt my eyes.
That's still bothering you. Well, I can run a few more tests if you like.
Yes, I think I'd like that. Will it take long?
Oh, shouldn't be too long. I just need to get things set up for you. Just sit tight and I'll be with you as soon as I can.
I'm a little worried. I hope Jonas can take a look at me soon.
Get out of my way, you stupid tunnel snakes!
What is it now, sir?
God, Butch! Why don't you just leave me alone?
What are you gonna do, Butch? Amata?
Go stay away from me!
Daddy on us? What's the matter? Daddy's girl gonna cry?
Show it to her, Butch!
Tell her, Butch!
Stupid tunnel snakes! Immature assholes, if you ask me! Why won't they leave me alone? It's not my fault my father's the overseer. I don't care about their stupid gang. Can you talk to them? Maybe Butch will listen to you. Please? A bunch of idiots, if you ask me. They think they're so tough with their gang. All they ever do is hang around and cause trouble. They've got it in for me because my father is the overseer. Like, that's my fault.
This is Vault 101, and you're enjoying a brighter
Thanks.
Future.
You've always been a good friend. Try talking to Butch. They'll all do whatever he says.
You think you're special because your daddy is the overseer?
Let's go into the storeroom, Amata. I'll show you a good time.
Tunnel snakes rule! That's us, and we rule! No one messes with the tunnel snakes, or they have to answer to Butch and Wally.
You don't want to be on their bad sides. Trust me. None of your business, because Butch said so. And what Butch says goes. Tunnel snakes rule! Because he's my pal, my brother. All us tunnel snakes are brothers. Birth to earth, womb to tomb. Mostly because tunnel snakes rule. Can't think of anything. Butch says this little bitch is blabbing to her daddy about us tunnel snakes. We can't have that. Because we're the tunnel snakes, and we rule. Much later, tunnel snakes rule. She thinks she's better than us. Yeah? What do you want? None of your business, kid. Get out of here before you get hurt. If you mess with the tunnel snakes, you're asking for it. Got me? And who are you? Her boyfriend? Ha! Keep talking like that, boy, and we'll send you back to your daddy with a few broken bones for him to fix. You've got to be kidding me. Come on, tunnel snakes. This twerp needs another lesson.
Butch, stop it. Leave him alone.
Another one just like that in my other hand.
Give him another one.
Hit him again.
This isn't solving anything. Stop it! This isn't solving anything!
Guys.
Come on, tunnel snakes. This little bitch isn't worth a... Okay. You win. We'll leave the little girl alone. You're not worth our time anyway. Come on, tunnel snakes. We're out of here. Whatever you say, Butch. You're the boss. Tunnel snakes rule. Hey, Susie, what's
new?
Fine,
let's go.
Oh,
what is it, Phoebe?
Our heater's on the fritz again.
You're kidding me. Didn't you just get new parts for it last week?
Yeah, sure did.
But the thing is so old.
God, that's
over. My grandpa had trouble with it when he was my age.
Thanks for getting rid of them. Assholes. I don't know why they won't leave me alone. Just because my father's the overseer, I guess? Idiots.
Well, I hope it's working again soon for you.
Thanks. Say, you want to grab some lunch later on?
Sure thing. How about we head down to the diner after class?
Great. Good luck on the goat.
You too.
Well, you made it. All set for the goat? Trust me, it really isn't that bad. Just something everybody has to go through. I'm sure you will, especially since it's multiple choice with no wrong answers. We'll start as soon as everyone's found a seat. Good luck. You don't want to be the first class in history to fail the goat, do you?
What? What do you want, nerd? We'll talk to your little friend later.
Yes?
I hope you weren't just talking to me.
Oh, hi. Why are you talking to me?
Go ahead, take a seat so we can start. As soon as everyone takes their seats, we can get started.
You nervous? I'm not.
Thanks for getting rid of them. I don't know why they...
What is it, Phoebe? Well, now that everyone has managed to find the classroom, we can finally get started. No talking, and keep your eyes to yourselves. Yes, I'm talking to you, Mr. Deloria.
Sure thing, Mr. Brotch.
Unless anyone else has an insightful comment, let's get started. Question one. A frenzied vault scientist runs up to you and yells, I'm going to put my quantum harmonizer in your photonic resonation chamber. What's your response? Question two. While working as an intern in the clinic, a patient with a strange infection in his foot stumbles through the door. The infection is spreading at an alarming rate, but the doctor has stepped out for a while. What do you do?
Question 3. You discover a young boy lost in the lower levels of the vault. He's hungry and frightened, but also appears to be in possession of stolen property. What do you do? Question 4. Congratulations. You've made one of the Vault 101 baseball teams. Which position do you prefer? Question 5. Your grandmother invites you to tea, but you're surprised when she gives you a pistol and orders you to kill another Vault resident. What do you do? Question 6. Old Mr. Abernathy has locked himself in his quarters again, and you've been ordered to get him out. How do you proceed? Question 7. Oh no! You've been exposed to radiation, and a mutated hand has grown out of your stomach. What's the best course of treatment? Question 8. A fellow Vault 101 resident is in possession of a Grognak the Barbarian comic book, issue number 1. You want it. What's the best way to obtain it? Question 9. You decide it would be fun to play a prank on your father. You enter his private restroom when no one is looking and... Question 10. Who is indisputably the most important person in Vault 101? He who shelters us from the harshness of the atomic wasteland and to whom we owe everything we have, including our lives. Pencils down, people. That's it. The infamous goat. I'm sure most of you didn't find it so bad. Others, well, there are always openings in the maintenance department. Don't forget to hand in your test before you leave. You don't want to know what happens to people who fail the goat. You can have the rest of the day off to celebrate or to pray, as the situation warrants. All finished? Looks like the diner is going to get a new fry cook. I'll just say this once. Hold the mustard. Extra pickles. Yes, it's refreshing to see such youthful enthusiasm. Good to know that the goat occasionally gets it right. You know what they say about monkeys and typewriters. Well, I'm glad things turned out so well for you. I hope your classmates find their results half as satisfying.
Get out of my face.
Here you are, Mr. Brotch. I hope I did okay.
Nothing for you to worry about, Miss Almodovar. Let's see. Very well done. Looks like it's the supervisory track for you.
Thanks. See you tomorrow.
You did fine. You should celebrate with your friends.
Yo, Teach! I'm done!
Ah, Butch. Can I admit that I've been waiting for this day for a long, long time? Allow me to savor the moment. Now then, let's see. Really? Interesting. You surprised me, Butch. I didn't think you had it in you. Hairdresser! Who would have thunk it?
You're so full of it. That isn't true!
You did fine. You should celebrate with your friends.
I'm all done, Mr. Brotch. I guess. Wait a second. Can I have it back? I think I need to change one of my answers.
Just calm down a minute, Paul. I'm sure you have nothing to worry about. Let's see. Yep, just as I thought. You're slated for the engineering track. Congratulations, Mr. Hannon. You've passed the GOAT.
Oh, gee. That's not so bad. Engineering, all right.
Mother can't wait to find out if I'll be going into science or home economics.
Science. Well, perhaps. Let's see what the GOAT says. Well, well. Maintenance department. I hope your mother will be pleased. I'm sure Stanley will be.
What? That's impossible. Bye. Mr. Brotch is a big fat liar. Mr. Brotch is a big fat liar.
I'm thinking of going with overseer for the last one. What did you put?
Back off.
Snake life forever.
Anything is possible, even an egg.
That is Mr. Brotch. He's here to save you now. Is he helping you get back to work?
Selfish and insubordinate.
Wake up!
You
come on, wake up!
I'm not going to be around to hold your hand forever.
Come on! You've got to wake up! You've got to get out of here! Your dad is gone and my father's men are looking for you! He's left the vault! I don't know how, but he's gone, and my father, he's kind of gone crazy. It's Jonas! They killed him! My father's men! They took him and... Oh my God, you have to leave now! Yeah, it's lucky I got here ahead of them, but we can't stand here talking. You've got to get out of here. Not this time. My father, he's not listening to anybody. If he even finds out that I've been helping you... But that doesn't matter. I can take care of myself. It's you he's looking for. And I have a plan. I know how to get you out of the vault. Well, I think it'll work. Listen. There's a secret tunnel that leads directly from my father's office to the exit. You'll have to hack the computer in his office to open it. Use these to get into his office. That's how I always get in. Oh, one more thing. I stole my father's pistol. I hope you won't need it, but you'd better take it just in case. I hope you're joking. Even with that pistol, I don't think you'll win a fight against the whole security force. Okay, I'll try to meet you at the exit. Good luck!